In the age of the internet, it's virtually impossible to escape the odd email or pop-up extolling astounding advances in the field of male enhancement. From miracle pills to powerful pumps to bizarre contraptions and even serious surgery, the sensitivity of penis size leaves countless men trying out untested and potentially unsafe methods. But one factor rather absent in the male enhancement racket is the impact of one's diet. Could it be that what you eat affects the size of your penis? Hi, it's Emily from BiteSize Vegan, and welcome to another Vegan Nugget. So far in the Men's Health series with Dr. Greger of NutritionFacts.org, we've covered the impact of diet on testosterone levels, erectile dysfunction, and prostate enlargement and cancer risk, as well as pitted soy against beer to see which has a stronger estrogenic effect on male hormones. Outside of the obvious, two common themes throughout this series have been the prevalent and disturbing predisposition of medical professionals to ignore prevention and simple and effective treatment in favor of ineffective and debilitating measures while keeping their patients in the dark to their own detriment, and the preponderance of medical evidence that the foods and beverages most associated with manliness in our society are the most damaging to men's health, while those deemed feminizing or emasculating actually lead to hormonal balance, virility, and unencumbered sexual performance, and of course have the added bonus of cancer prevention and enhancing overall health. In this fifth and final installment in the series, we'll address perhaps the most stereotypical, often trivialized, yet intensely personal and sensitive topic of penis size. While this may appear to be purely an issue of ego, as with the previous topics in this series, the dietary factors affecting penis size have significant health impacts beyond that singular manifestation. So let's hear from Dr. Greger for what the science says about size.
I mean, the male enhancement industry is astoundingly large. So is there actually a dietary link to the size of male genitalia?
Women like to, size doesn't matter. But if you actually ask them in surveys when men aren't around, 3/4 of women consider penile length and girth to be somewhat or very important, supposedly. That's the largest survey ever performed. And you say, well, wait a second, what does that have to do with diet? Well, there are these phthalates, these phthalate chemicals, which are kind of industrial pollutants. These are plastic made in the plastics industry. Oh, in fact, I actually had a video recently about phthalates in sex toys. You should check that out. So there's phthalate implications for women too, but in terms of for men, so these phthalate industrial pollutants, how do we become exposed? What they did is they did this survey where they measure phthalate urine levels, which is an indicator of how much is flowing through your bodies, and then they looked at did dietary analyses, and they found exactly what is in the diet that's leading to the highest levels. And so they were looking for something called MEHP, one of the phthalates that's associated with smaller penis size in infants. So if pregnant women are exposed to a lot of phthalates, their infant sons are born with smaller penises and lots of other more meaningfully negative effects.
In addition to a smaller penis, MEHP appears to increase the odds of boys later growing breasts 25-fold, and then decrease testosterone later in life. The chicken phthalates have also been associated with increased odds of cesarean section, diminished child intelligence, particularly in boys, attention deficit and hyperactivity disorder, ADHD symptoms, later in life with abdominal obesity, altered thyroid function, damaged sperm, and a lower sperm count.
And actually, poultry consumption was associated most with MEHP levels in the urine. And it wasn't clear exactly. We're not sure where that's actually coming from. Originally, they thought, well, it's from a plastic. It's from the plastic that's wrapping the chicken. But it turns out eggs really have high phthalate levels as well. So it may be coming from the chicken itself, and perhaps something that we're feeding the chickens. It's not particularly sure. And so I have a video about this kind of feminization of male genitalia with maternal phthalate consumption. But, you know, I think for men who are going to this video and being like, oh, well, you know, I kind of have no control over what my mom ate, but what about now? What about I'm out of the womb? Is there anything that I eat that is going to affect the length of my penis? And there is actually, I have a video coming up. There's a different class of pollutants, these PCBs, certain classes of PCBs that can actually affect the size of penis. These are in boys, found predominantly in fish. And so they found that that boys who ate a lot of fish containing a lot of this PCB pollutants actually grew up with shortened penises. We're talking 3/4 of an inch at the most, so it wasn't a really big effect. And of course, as with all industrial pollutants, the strategy is to eat as low as possible on the food chain. And so plants would be the ideal. And then, of course, stay away from the aquatic food chain as much as possible, because everything eventually flows into the sea, our oceans, our humanity's sewers. And so, unfortunately, without a time machine, it's very difficult to go back before the Industrial Revolution and get non-contaminated seafood.
I hope you found what Dr. Greger shared to be helpful. I've included more in-depth information, further resources, citations to specific studies, and more of Dr. Greger's videos and essays on the blog post for this video, linked in the description below. It is so vital that men, and actually everyone, are proactive about their health. Unfortunately, relying on our doctors and the medical industry in its current state can be severely detrimental to our well-being. Even fatal, and perpetuating the ideas of manliness ingrained within our cultures and societies under the charge of preserving tradition or fighting overly PC culture actually contributes to the decline in men's health and leads to more men dying prematurely. The good news is that there are more and more solid resources for evidence-based nutrition and health information. And luckily, when it comes to the influence of diet, a heightened sexual performance, prevent prostate cancer and enlargement, balance hormones, and maybe avoid losing some length, the answer is the same across the board. Now, to make sure that you're getting the male-enhancing nutrition you need, check out Chronometer, a free website and app that I've used in several of my videos because of its uniquely detailed nutrition reports and ease of use. Chronometer has reached out to help sponsor the Men's Health series to get this vital educational information out to those who need it. Click the link in the description or go here to make your free profile. It's not an affiliate link, but it will let Chronometer know that BiteSize Vegan sent you. On a personal note, even though I'm well aware of the misinformation and disinformation rampant within the medical industry, through making the Men's Health series, I've become more and more frustrated and astounded by the level and nature of misinformation surrounding these issues. When that's compounded with social and cultural taboos about manliness and discussing these kind of issues, health concerns that literally mean life and death for men are reduced to comedic memes or written off as inevitabilities of aging. To help combat this and actually save men's lives, please share this video and the information and the whole series to help men take hold of their health. The more we talk about it, the less of a stigma it has, and the more access men can have to real life-saving information. Be sure to subscribe to the channel and click the bell to enable notifications for more fresh vegan content every week. To support free education like this, please see the support links below, click the Nugget Army icon, or the link in the sidebar. Now go live vegan, enhance your health, and I'll see you soon. Usually I'm trying to figure out how to title videos in a way that makes it engaging and something people want to click on without being clickbait and totally inaccurate. But with this video, it's like impossible to title it in a way that doesn't look like clickbait, even when it's completely accurate as to the contents of the video. That's weird.